there are probably a few things. One is that big tech got big, I think is one aspect, right? And there's always this default, people have innate temperaments, and among those who are more egalitarian in streak, they will be more critical of, call it larger and wealthier organizations, except if it's the government, that's okay. Once companies get big, they basically become, they enter focus for this style of criticism. 10 years ago, Facebook, Google, these, even Microsoft, they were not so big. They were not trillion-dollar companies, right? So they were, and they didn't have so much power. So I don't think they attracted as much attention. A, they got big, and B, I mean, some real problems did start occurring on social media, right? These companies grew as fast as possible, but embraced an attitude of human society and human actors are generally good people. We're generally going to assume good actors and good intentions. And I think around a few years ago, last kind of two election cycles ago, people figured out how to use these powerful social networks for malicious means. And that obviously caused significant damage and credibility to these companies. But it also gave the press for the first time, like tangible narratives to say why big tech is bad. The other side, of course, to consider is that while large tech has been growing, their business success has been completely at the detriment of the traditional business of print media and now increasingly kind of TV. So I think it's impossible to say, it would be far too naive to say that the fact that their businesses are crumbling. And every time, I read an article from one of these newspapers, they're literally either asking me for donations or paywalling me or otherwise like struggling to kind of even be a viable entity. Like they can't be feeling good. If they were in a healthier state, maybe I think they would be less bitter and less divisive about this stuff. But I think the simultaneous factors of their business crumbling and large tech becoming essentially more influential than nation states is kind of causing this division. And of course, that's on the media side. If you look at what's happening with, there are individuals who feel this way too. Like part of the reason they write these articles is because they're readers who want to read this narrative. And I think at a very macroscopic scale, the effect of technology has been to magnify, outcome inequality for people in the world. I think you could, there's a great debate to be had about, is that the natural state of things or is that an artificial induced state of things? I tend to think that it's magnifying kind of underlying realities in the world that were masked by kind of the prior eras of society and economics. But that's a reasonable debate to be had. But I think the fact is technology has allowed, call it the top 10% of people with skills, with high leverage skills, call it the top 10% of people there to basically accumulate exponentially more wealth, while good, honest labor, which used to earn a good, honest living, has decayed because of globalization, automation, and all these other things. So that's magnified a huge gap that didn't exist 10, 20 years ago as much. And naturally, those who are on the wrong end of that bargain, they need a narrative to explain their outcomes because they're just simply unlucky relative to what's happening to the world. And I think it's understandable that they're kind of upset that, the world is working against them in almost a secular way.